And now we're going to move to another Charlie, Charlie Bobrinskoy of Ariel Investments. He's the vice chairman and head of the investment group there. Charlie, you're joining us from Chicago. It's good to see you as well. So zooming out from Target to the broader market here and the remarkable resiliency that we have seen in stocks overall, as you rightly point out to us in a note, a lot of that has to do with technology. But overall, we've seen markets lift. Are investors missing something, do you think?
Well, I think it's important to talk about different kinds of stocks. We do all tend to talk in terms of the market is represented by the S&P 500. But as we all know, the S&P 500 is really overweight large cap technology. And the average stock hasn't done nearly as well as the S&P 500. We're value investors, small and mid-cap value investors. And the Russell 2500 value index is still down 25-26% year to date. So we don't think the market had the market in our stocks has been too optimistic. We do think the S&P 500 FANG stocks, those companies are doing well in this environment. And we think the stock market has a tendency to overestimate and overweight the short term. The stock market's very short-term focused, and it's loving the names that are doing well in this environment. In our opinion, there's going to be some regression to the mean. We're going to get to the other side of this. We're getting to the other side of this in some ways faster than people thought. And when we do, some of our value names are going to do very well compared to these large cap tech growth stocks.
Hey, Charlie, it's Adam Shapiro. Is one of those value names what you consider what I would call old media and have made my career in television, for instance, CBS, Viacom? I think a lot of people are ready to write off, quote, old media, but that might be a mistake.
Absolutely. The stock got down to 10, which was about 2.5 times earnings. We think they're going to earn about $4 a share. And that's just silly. I mean, CBS announced its results yesterday. They are still the most watched broadcast network. You might say, oh, that doesn't matter anymore. In fact, one of the things that's happened with coronavirus is people are cutting the cord. They are putting old rabbit ears or antennas up on their TVs, and they're actually watching more broadcast TV. So I'm not saying we're going to have the spectacular growth that Netflix is going to have, but the stock has about doubled since their earnings came out. It's gone from 10 to about 20. And it's still, in our opinion, way too cheap at less than 5 times earnings. Just quickly, everything that could go wrong for Viacom CBS went wrong this year. They had the Final Four and the NCAA basketball tournament canceled. They had the Masters canceled. They had Paramount, had a new Top Gun movie coming out, a new Quiet Place movie coming out. All of that got canceled. It's going to come back. And this stock should be trading for a lot more than 4.5 times earnings.
Hey, Charlie, Rick Newman here. I want to revisit your remark about this, the short-term focus of the stock market. Is the stock market's short-term focus shorter than it used to be? I mean, we keep seeing these rallies on almost nothing. We just had a rally recently on this one vaccine test of 8 people. I mean, single digits. And we're scratching our heads like, really, that's enough to send the stock market up by 1 or 2% in a day? So is there something about the environment now that makes the stock market even more focused on the short term or on even shorter horizon?
You know, people like me have always complained about this stock market being too short term focused. But if you just do simple math on the discounted cash flow value of a stock, you're going to find that more than 90% of the value is not in the first year. In other words, less than 10% of the value of a stock comes from cash flows in the next 12 months. And what the market does tend to do is focused on the next quarter and are they going to beat next quarter? If you're a hedge fund, if you're an ARB, you're trying to win short-term bets. We think the only way to be a good investor is to be patient and to buy things that have some short-term headwinds, but have good long-term prospects. And that's what we're finding in abundance right now. There are lots of companies that we will admit have headwinds in the current environment. Frankly, we think that environment is getting better faster than people thought. And those companies right now are the stocks that are attractive.
And Charlie, speaking of that idea, I want to bring up another one of your picks, and that's Zimmer, which makes replacement hips and joints. As we know, a lot of elective surgeries in most places are not happening right now. At some point they will. Is this the kind of thing where you do get that catch up in demand?
Yeah, I mean, we think demand for hips and knees is certainly not going away. And that is the question. We think we could actually have pent up demand and actually have a better than expected fourth quarter. It's probably going to be a little, I don't want to call that in the third quarter, but I think we could have pent up demand in the fourth quarter for lots of elective surgeries. If you've seen pictures of hospitals, the operating rooms are basically empty right now. And that is just not sustainable longer term. We have other names like Hanger, which makes orthotics. Artificial limb demand is not going to go away permanently, but it has gone away in the short run. And so we think there are a number of these companies with real pent-up demand. You're seeing the lines forming outside of casinos. There's pent-up demand for casinos. We think there are sectors that are actually going to see this V recovery that so many people have been saying can't happen.
Charlie, and just quickly, the patients that you were talking about, are your clients also as patients? In other words, or are they sort of a self-selecting group, whereas if they're putting their money with Ariel, they know what they're getting?
Yeah, it's a great question. In 08 and 09, we had a lot of outflows. This time around, we haven't. And I think people do realize they can see how poorly value has done relative to these growth stocks. If they wanted to own Amazon and Netflix, they wouldn't have put the money into us, or they had another investor, another manager who was in those stocks. So our investors know what they have, and they don't think this is a good time to be selling value. They can look at our stocks trading at an average of around 11, 12, 13 times, and the S&P at 20 times. They don't think now is a good time to get out of value.
All right. Good to know. Charlie, good to see you. Charlie Bobrinskoy is Ariel Investments Vice Chairman and head of the investment group.
Hey, investors. Zach Guzman here. Are you interested in learning more about the markets and getting the latest financial news? Well, then click right here to subscribe to our Yahoo Finance YouTube channel. Get the latest up-to-the-minute market analysis, big interviews in the world of finance, and information on how to manage your money every day, wherever you are.